είναι το πρώτο σπίτι που νοικιάσαμε για τα πρώτα μας EVS. Τη Γιάννα από τη Βουλγαρία και τον Άλεξ από τη Ρουμανία.
So, what do I remember from my EVS experience? It's really one of the most amazing things I've done in my life. I'm really happy that I ended up in Thessaloniki and in this certain organization. I was together with another colleague and with Aris. We were just three people, but we had a very crazy experience, very unique, I would say. So what I mostly remember are the people that I met there. I traveled a lot. It was a great exchange of culture, languages, mentality and everything else. We did great things in the organizations. We did a lot of local trainings. I traveled a lot. I did some on-arrival midterm trainings. I met people from all over Europe that actually I still stay in contact with, and we're still friends. What I also wanted to say is that my project was very interesting. I worked in the online radio. I worked for the database music from all over the Balkans. You know, we were setting up the basis, so it was really exciting, really special, and yes, that's all.
Από το 2009 μέχρι και το 2015 υπήρξα συντονιστής περίπου 180 παιδιών που ήρθαν από το πρόγραμμα Ευρωπαϊκή Εθελοντική Υπηρεσία, το E.V.S. Μετά το 2015 υπάρχουν άλλοι συνάδελφοι που ασχολούνται με αυτό το κομμάτι. Από τα δύο παιδιά που ξεκίνησαν το 2009 και μείνανε στο πρώτο σπίτι που είδαμε και προηγουμένως, έπειτα ήρθαν τρία παιδιά, στη συνέχεια ήρθαν έξι παιδιά και καταλήξαμε να έχουμε μέχρι το 2015, όπως είπε, 180 νέους από διάφορες χώρες της Ευρωπαϊκής Ένωσης ή και εκτός. Ήταν κάτι πολύ πρωτόγνωρο για τα άτομα που υπάρχουν στην περιοχή της Ανοπόλης, για τους κατοίκους της περιοχής, κάτοικοι οι οποίοι κατά κόρον είναι οικογένειες ή άτομα μιας κάποιας ηλικίας. Φανταστείτε τώρα να υπάρχουν άτομα τα οποία είναι νέοι σε ηλικία από διάφορες χώρες, να μην μιλάνε ελληνικά και να πρέπει να ψωνίσουν από το φαρμακείο της περιοχής, από το μανάβικο, από τον μπακάλικο, να πηγαίνουν να μαθαίνουν παραδοσιακούς χορούς εδώ στο πολιτιστικό σύλλογο της περιοχής. Πόσο αυτό μεγάλο βήμα ήταν για την περιοχή να ανοιχτεί έτσι, να ανοίξει ορίζοντές της και να γνωρίσει κάτι διαφορετικό από αυτούς. Πολλές αστείες ιστορίες, πολλά αναπάντεχα πράγματα και πράγματα τα οποία θα ήθελα να ξεχάσω. Νέοι οι οποίοι πήραν μέρος στα προγράμματα αυτά, οι οποίοι γνωρίσαν τον εαυτό τους καλύτερα, ήρθαν σε σημαντικές προκλήσεις και μπορέσαν και αναπτυχθήκανε. Νέοι που μέχρι τώρα έχουν φτάσει σε κάποιες θέσεις πολύ ψηλές, οι οποίες θέσεις δεν νομίζω ότι φαντάζονταν και οι ίδιοι όπως λένε σε μένα, ότι θα μπορούσαν ποτέ να επιτευχθεί κάτι τέτοιο στη ζωή τους. Και ξεκίνησαν όλα από εδώ, από τα ερεθίσματα που πήραν από εδώ, από την ανάπτυξη που ξεκίνησε στη ζωή τους εδώ. Τουλάχιστον ένα αστείο να πω. Σε αριθμούς τουλάχιστον, από όσο γνωρίζω εγώ από τις ζυμώσεις των εθελοντών μεταξύ τους και από τις ζυμώσεις που έχουν γίνει με Θεσσαλονικείς, έχουν γεννηθεί τουλάχιστον 6 παιδιά. Και αυτό είναι κάτι.
First of all, I remember exploring Greece, exploring Thessaloniki from the other side than the postcard. You know, many, especially Danish people, people from the north, they know Greece only as a place you go on vacation on the island. And maybe sometimes about economic crisis from the news. But what I got to learn was the real Greece, the Greece of the Greek people, and it is completely different than these images. In my building where I was living, there was in the basement a dance class with a traditional Greek dance. And of course I wanted to also learn about this aspect, so I joined the class, even though it was in Greek. And even though I was the youngest in the group, the rest we could say was people in, they were middle-aged people, they were 40 plus, and no one was really speaking English. So every week I joined this class. I was very bad compared to the rest who had been dancing all their life. So you can imagine me trying to follow along and not really being able to.
What I remember is that we were much more people. We were like 15 up to 17 people in my experience in U.S.B. We've been a lot and we did a lot of things, a lot of projects. I was making some articles with so interesting people that I met, some Olympic sportsmen, and really I remember the people mostly, like people that I live with, the nice Italians, French, Turkish that I met in my life, and I still keep in contact with most of them. I met one very nice friendship, like one best friend in my life is what I found there. And yeah, I remember also my Kalara mood then, and I always keep it for myself and to remind myself that it's important to be Kalara in the moment.
Έμαθα πολλά πράγματα, δεξιότητες, ικανότητες, αλλά πέρα από αυτά απέκτησα μία εμπειρία ζωής. Έκανα φιλίες, έκανα σχέσεις και αυτές οι σχέσεις με τράβηξαν ξανά στην Ελλάδα. Τώρα άλλη μια φορά ήρθα για να σπουδάσω. Πέρασα 8 μήνες κάθε μέρα στη U.S.B. Γι' αυτό το λόγο έχουμε πολλές αστείες στιγμές. Αλλά θυμάμαι μία φορά πήγαμε στην Αθήνα για ένα συνέδριο και όταν γυρίσαμε κάναμε πολύ πλάκα με τον Άρη. Θυμάμαι επειδή είμαστε μόνη οργάνωση στην Ελλάδα που έχει περισσότερους άνδρες εθελοντές από γυναίκες. Γι' αυτό το λόγο κάναμε πολύ πλάκα.
If I have to be honest, so many things happened for almost a year in Greece. But I just said that nothing happened by accident there. And what came to my mind is that on my first month I had an accident because I went to one of those student parties in the Thessaloniki University. So I fell down, I broke my foot. That was really absurd. And I had to stay in a cast for over a month. But the funny part was me going to the office every day with the crutches. But I think the best part was Aris and Ioana, who were extremely supportive. They were so nice. And something else funny, it was like, I think, the whole Greek experience. So if I have to think about Greece, it will always, in my mind, it will always be connected to fun. And the serious part, I think the serious part was mostly Aris. Sometimes, from time to time, when he decided that he wanted to give me like a last minute assignment, he would sound like the most serious person on earth, and the other serious person was my Romanian colleague and flatmate. So yeah, that's it. How about you?
Well, about the funny thing, well, now it doesn't sound so funny, but then I was eating pasta almost every day. I was living with Italians and I took like 3 or 4 kilos in the first 2 months. And it was a bit tragic from now, from the point of view of now. But then it was just funny because it was so delicious and I was there. And yeah, what about the serious things? I don't know. Nothing was so serious there, I think.
Welcome to our balcony. We have a great Thessaloniki view. This is one of the best things of our EVS life. Thanks for the U.S.B. Thanks for the Aris and Olympia. Coffee for the wake up and the beautiful Thessaloniki view. Enjoy it.
Here is very nice. I met lots of people and every people are different viewpoint and we are learning each other lots of things. You can discover yourself and you can improve yourself and you can gain new viewpoint. It's very important. Do it.